to take care of the paint, particularly in that fourth quarter?
I think we ran them off the three-point line. Granted, they had some good looks down the stretch that they missed, but for the most part, I thought we did a great job running them off the line and then contesting their shots at the rim. And if a big came over for the rotation help, the guard did a great job of cracking down, keeping Gobert or Favors off the glass or whoever cut to the basket and finished the plays with rebounds. So I just thought our physicality just stepped up even more in the fourth quarter.
Three straight games now that you guys have kind of won those gut check moments. Mm-hmm. What's working in those fourth quarters lately?
I want to say our mindset. But we just take it up to the next level, running plays more fluently on the offensive side of the ball. PG, Russ, Melo just stepping up. Dre Day doing a great job on the defensive side of the ball. And also Stevens just being remarkable on the boards, finishing around the rim, using his body to his advantage out there. So I just think everyone is just stepping up and doing a little bit extra down the stretch.
You on the floor with Jeremy and Raymond and Andre and Paul to start the fourth quarter. You guys held them to 2 points first 4.5 minutes, and that allowed you guys to get back in the game. How satisfying is it to know that when Billy goes to the bench, you guys can produce and make victory possible?
Yeah, it's very satisfying. You know, when the bench comes in and we don't retreat, we don't have any lapses. It's definitely positive momentum for us. It's very satisfying, and for us to come in and give us some momentum, and then the starters come back in and just build on that and just take it up another notch. It was good for us.
It seemed like the energy was really good with that group. Was that a conscious thing? I mean, did you guys have a sense of how much you needed?
We just know we need to get stops. So whatever it took, you know, I thought those guys did a great job switching on the corner. Me just trying to communicate, you know, whenever it's a pick and roll, just finish plays with rebounds. And I just thought we executed quite well on the offensive side of the ball. Hit shots when we needed hit shots. PG stepped up, and everyone else just stepped up when needed to.
Specifically,
from Russell, in terms of the way he conducted in the fourth quarter when he came back after you guys stopped
him. Him just being vocal in the huddles, on the court, him just taking over. You know, when he sees one shot going in, he's just going to continue to keep shooting the ball, and it was just one after the other going in. Defensive side, him just being more active against the ball, pushing the ball in transition, finding guys and teammates open, running plays that led to open opportunities for Melo, PG, and Steven with the role. So him just being that floor general just stepped up down the stretch.
What did he say in the huddle on that floor?
I can't tell you. Yeah, that stays with us. But I can definitely tell you it's nothing but positive.
That lineup at the start of the fourth quarter, you guys were having so much success, specifically trapping guys, whether on the baseline, at the wing, wherever else. What's the trick to being able to execute that kind of aggressive trapping while still being able to maintain the defense throughout the possession?
Just use our length. I think we'll use our wingspan to our advantage, talking, communication. Guys just letting each other know that there's help there. I thought they did a great job of getting into their man, getting into the ball, forcing them downhill into the help. And when the help was needed, the help was there, finish plays and rebounds. So I just thought our length, our size, and overall just us getting into the ball and being physical just helped.
Anything else? Thanks, Pat.
Thank you, Pat.